So then, if you see, on the other hand, that existence is musical in nature, that is to say that it is not serious, it is a play.
Cricket started for me. It started with myself, my cousins, and my friend Mark, Kevin, Harris. When we started to play on the road, take the cricket from the road into the yard, from the yard into the settlement in the back of the homes. Started to play cricket anywhere possible, to be honest. I think that's where I fall in love with the game. And from then, I knew that, you know, cricket is going to be my profession. And that's the only thing I've ever been thinking about from then to now. You know, my father, he always pushed me as well. My mother supported me as well. I remember when I was playing on a 13 cricket, you know, I felt like I really wanted to be good. So I used to ask my dad to throw balls at me regardless, you know, come as close as possible, throw the ball as quick as possible to me in exchange ground. Sometimes I used to play in the yard, the hard ball into the yard. I'd smash a couple into my mother, you know, windows, into the doors, smash a couple glass. That this one time that I hit my dad's van, just bought a new van, a Navara van. And I was hitting the ball and socks. And I kind of had this high back lift, and it smashed his van and left a dent. And it was a new vehicle. I remember, you know, just trying to hide and wake up in the morning like, you know, nothing happened. And, you know, I woke up that morning with my dad bawling, "Nicholas, come here!" And I got some serious licks, you know, for denting his van. And, you know, cricket has been everything for me so far. I can't remember. I always used to remember, even in the side roads, the bigger guys used to play windball cricket. And, you know, I was going to primary school. And, you know, parents always want you to do your homework before you can go and, you know, play any sport. So every time my mom goes to sleep or she goes to the back of the house, even my dad, I used to run away, try to go and play with these guys. And as soon as my mom or dad wakes up or they realize that I'm missing, they're like, "Nicholas, where are you?" And you know, that was really funny. Sometimes my mom, she comes to her belt looking for me as well. And my father, the same thing. But, you know, looking back at it, that's, you know, wonderful memories for me. You know, I would never trade it for anything. And that's been my, you know, my journey so far. You know, I've made my debut for Trinidad senior team at 17. You know, everyone thought I had potential at a young age. You know, I made 33 not out, and, you know, I've never looked back from then. I got selected in CPL, I think it was the year after, or that same year. You know, Dwayne Bravo picked me up. And, you know, David Jacobs was another keeper. He was the next keeper, but he was injured. So I got the opportunity to play the first game. I remember, you know, playing in Providence Stadium in Guyana. We were chasing like 150, and we lost 2 wickets. Score was like 60 for 2. And Bravo was like, "You're next." I'm like, "Me? All right, cool." I said, "Just go and enjoy yourself." And I remember going out there. I made 54 in my first actual game against Sunil Narine, Mohammed Hafiz, a lot of guys. And that was the turning point of my career. You know, after that, you know, everyone keep, you know, backing my potential. You know, everyone said they have seen something special in me. And then I couldn't see it because all I wanted to do was just play cricket. You know, and then, you know, after playing that, I went on to play on a 19 World Cup. I did really well for myself and for my team there. Unfortunately, we got knocked out in the quarterfinals there. After that, I got into an accident. Unfortunate, but it's fine. You know, I've learned a lot of things from that accident so far. It's been difficult for me, but at the end of the day, I'm really happy that, you know, it happened. It taught me a lot about life, a lot about, you know, everything I've been going through, that it's happened for a reason. I have never questioned it up to now. You know, today, 5 years now from the accident, and up to now, I didn't even question why it happened to me. You know, I just look at the positives from it. And, you know, five years ago, I was thinking whether I could play the game or not. You know, people said, you know, "You'll never be the same again. You may not even play the game again." That's fine, you know, it started to frustrate me a bit, but at the end of the day, all I did was look back at, you know, 10, 15 years ago, and, you know, all I wanted to do was play cricket, and I felt like nothing was going to stop me from, you know, playing cricket again, despite whatever happened. You know, doctors didn't have as much faith, but, you know, I must say my physio back then, Uber Goldstone, I didn't know who to trust, to be honest. And you know, I trusted him. Every day he started to, you know, motivate me. He said, "Oh, it's gonna be fine. You're gonna be alright in 6 months, 7 months, 8 months." And you know, every day I go to therapy. I'm starting to see improvements. It was difficult. My legs couldn't bend. I couldn't walk properly. I was all over the shop, to be honest. And you know, I put my belief into him. And in a year time, I was ready to go again. You know, I put my faith in my God, Jesus Christ. You know, because of him, I'm here again today. You know, playing this wonderful sport. And you know, I'm here to show the world the talent he's blessed me with. I'm happy to play the game again. And you know, as I said, it's fine. My career, my short career this far hasn't been so smooth, but it's fine. You know, this is life. You know, we don't always get it the way we want it. Started to play cricket again. I made my international debut the year after in Dubai against Pakistan. At that point, has given me the opportunity to, you know, experience different things, learn from different players, learn different conditions, how other players think. And I felt like, most importantly, I learned the game, you know, faster than I thought I would. You know, I'm still learning every single day. You learn, and you know, I'm happy that, you know, my career is going along this path, despite whatever happened. I think I have a really good story. You know, all I can say now is that, you know, every single time I try to doubt myself, I just try to remember why I'm playing this game. And simply because, you know, I enjoy it, and this is the only thing I really know, to be honest. I know how to hit a six, I know how to hit a four, I know how to run and catch, I know how to support, I know how to give 100% on a cricket field. And looking back, that's when I was not playing cricket professionally, all I wanted to do was just enjoy the game of cricket. You know, that's fine. And today I'm really happy, you know. One of my dreams was playing IPL cricket, I remember, you know, sitting every Saturday morning, Saturday and Sunday, looking at, you know, back-to-back IPL games, wondering if I will ever play IPL. Mumbai Indians gave me an opportunity, my first opportunity to IPL, and you know, meeting you know, the legends of the game, Sachin, being in the same dressing room with him, I'm very thankful. And I think, you know, whilst I've gone through so much things in my career so far, I think it's a dream for me, and my story can't get any better. If it gets better, then you know, I'm very thankful. But you know, I appreciate my story so far, and it's something that I will never forget. I'll never forget where I came from, and that's most important for me. And just going forward, you know, I'm happy to be in the IPL again. You know, Kings 11, you know, retained me last year, and I'm so happy that I could, you know, go there and execute my plans and skills and show the world the talent I have. And this is what I'm doing right now, and you know, I don't want to change anything, but just continue winning games and see to the end for Kings 11 Punjab. And you know, hopefully I can make, you know, Kings fans and my fans, you know, happy of me now and in the future. And I hope I make everyone proud.